your hand. If you serve the world in some way in front of groups or circles, the moon circles, awesome. Okay, great. Yes, Ashkenazi Shabbat Fire Fair, beautiful. So she's a Speak to Inspire coach, and she's one of our FemTalks speaker coaches. She comes in and imparts so much wisdom to the women in our community about how to be on stage, how to like fully be in your heart, your belly, your pelvis, your breath, your voice, while you are serving your clients and your workshops and your programs and your retreats and your women's circles. So we want to warmly welcome her. We're going to unveil our authenticity through fun, interactive group exercises that bring out her most confident and engaging stage presence. Let's put our hands together and give a warm FemTalks welcome to Julia Beecham. Thank you, ladies.
Wow. You can have a seat.
So Jessica asked how many of you think of yourselves as speakers. I've got two hands up back there, but actually maybe not so many of you raised your hand. So for those of you that didn't raise your hand, do you have your own business?
Oh.
So if you have your own business, you are a speaker, you're the messenger of your business. You're the messenger of your business. So for everybody, because we're all speakers in whatever way we are, how many of you are comfortable being vulnerable on stage? Okay, interesting, good. That was like half the group. Good, we're some vulnerable women. Okay, so for me, I've spent way too much time in my life worried about what other people think of me. Anybody else in that boat? Yeah, so when I was 9 years old, I was the kid that left the party early and ran out to the backyard, hid behind some bushes when my friends came to look for me. When I was in middle school, I was the girl with the limited, it was cool then, the limited sweater that I thought was so cool, and I'd walk down the hallway with my chest lifted. I was feeling so self-conscious about what people thought of me. And I was the girl in eighth grade who was best friends with the coolest girl in school, Sarah White, and Sarah White always wore pink. She wore her pink little skirt and her pink top with little ruffles and her hair with a ponytail. And so what did I have to do? I went home, Mom, I have to wear all pink. Because I had to be like Sarah White. And then when I got into college, I went into all my acting classes. And still there, my teacher said to me, Julia, get out of your own way. Get out of your head. You're stopping yourself. When I ended up in physical theater training in Poland, my teacher came up in the middle of a song. Put his hand and his thumb on my forehead. Didn't say a word, but I knew that he was saying, get out of your head. It was when I was in high school and I miraculously got the lead in the play. I was cast as this 35-year-old woman with two kids. Her husband's cheating on her. There was murder. It was crazy. How did I know what was going on? I was overwhelmed by this role. But I jumped in, and in the performance, that's where I got to be big. That's where I got to be big and emotional and messy. And I realized in that moment that being on stage is where we get to be fully expressed, where we get to be vulnerable and authentic. And that's what I've been exploring since then, really. But what I find is that entrepreneurs that I work with and when I go into corporate don't think that being up on stage is the place to be big. They think of being on stage is where you put your mask on. So that's what we're here to talk about, vulnerability on stage, and how vulnerability is actually the client magnet that you're looking for. What is vulnerability on stage? Well, let's define it, because vulnerability on stage, when I hear vulnerability, I think like, we need to like cry, right? We need to get really vulnerable and share all our deep, but I don't think that vulnerability has to be that. It can be your joy. It can be your pleasure. It can be your excitement and your passion. So there's a simple mindset shift that I want to offer you here before we dive into actually some fun exercises. And this is going to be like the foundation for the whole night. So when it comes to being on stage, there's really three kinds of ways that you can show up in terms of your stage presence. There's internal presence. That means the kind of presence that you're practicing when you meditate, when you go to yoga class, where you're feeling your sensations, you're watching your breath, you're aware of your thoughts. Internal presence. And if you bring your internal presence to the stage, put people to sleep. So we're here to talk about this, this, and this, and that doesn't really inspire people too far. Right. But on the other side, external presence is all outside of you, and you are way out there, and everything's out there, right? Too big, too overwhelming. Everybody was like, whoa. So the third way is somewhere in the middle, it's a balance, where we stay internally present and we're externally present at the same time. And how I really have honed in on this is like, have you seen my Facebook Live videos? I've been doing a lot of videos lately. Super fun. My best friend who lives on the East Coast called me and said, Julia, can I give you some feedback about your videos that might sound a little strange? And I was expecting something sort of bad. But she said, Julia, you sound like a real person on my videos. I was like, I think that's a compliment. And my other best friend here in Berkeley who sees me talk live, he says, you know, you're just yourself up on stage, but a little bit more energized. So, you know, that's what it's really about. How can we just be an extension of ourselves up on stage, but a little bit more energized? I say that we need 5 to 10% higher energy on stage than in regular life. So that's a bit of what we're going to work on today, is raising your energy so that even when you network later, you are the light in the room that people want to talk to. Does that sound good?
Yes. Yes.
Awesome. I love it too. They're always really responsive. Please stand up, get on your feet. Bring your feet underneath you. Put anything down that's in your hand. Let our arms drop. We're going to start with that internal presence. So go ahead and close your eyes or turn them downward. Shift from the outer world to your inner world. And just notice. How are you tonight? How's your body? What's the state of your physical body tonight? There might be parts that feel tight, tense. What parts that feel spacious? How's your mind? What's the quality of your thinking tonight? Are there any looming thoughts? What's on your heart tonight? And where's your connection to that something bigger? Source, God, universe. Take a moment to also notice any places of armoring, resistance, tightness, and any aspects of yourself that we just talked about. Notice I'm going into that internal presence voice to calm you down. And then deepen your breath. Begin the shift from this inner world. We'll eventually come back to the external world in a few moments. Deeper breaths, much deeper. As you're ready, bring your hands up to your jaw joint and start to massage the muscles there. The reason we're taking a moment for our jaws is because your mouth, your jaw joint, is the valve of your vulnerability. Your jaw joint is the valve of your vulnerability. In these muscles holds all the things that you've been told you can't say. It's inappropriate to say, it's too big, it's too bold, it's too wild. Take a breath and let anything go out your mouth. Go a little deeper into the jaw, bring the heels of your hands to the top of your jaw joint. Quick, do it because it's fine. Press in through the heels of your hands toward each other. Breathe through your mouth. We'll slide down for 10, 9, slowly sliding, 8, 7, breathe deep, 5, 4, 3. two, and one, release. Move your mouth, pick choose. Like your biggest ball of gum ever, like you're good at that. And let that big open mouth lead you to a luscious yawn.
Maha.
Joanna Banana.
Joanna Banana.
Jillian.
work out any of those thoughts, those subconscious thoughts. We're going to leave those behind with this exercise. So I call this a ball of energy exercise. How it works is that it's as if you have, like this ball of energy, and we're going to swoosh it to the side, and it starts to become this, it's some force of its own, basically, around the room. And just listen first how it could sound. I like when it's a guttural sound, like, whoa, ha, whoo, you know, something like that. This, tap your belly. Get that nice guttural spot. Yeah, you're going to want to bend your knees. And you're going to do something like this. Do that with me. Some swooshing movement. And if that ball of energy is moving right through you. Okay, so I'll start it and make it move as quickly as you can. Don't let it drop. It's like if you're juggling, you keep the balls up in the air. Ready? And for 5-10 minutes, and I do a comprehensive overview of your speaking. Now, there's so many things to look for in speaking, and usually our friends and family are like, oh, this feels good. You ever get feedback? If you get feedback, it's really broad. So this is an opportunity to get incredibly specific, expert feedback on your speaking. So my one-on-one time is usually $250 an hour, so the value of this session, which is an hour and a half, is $375. But for the ladies tonight, because I've been in this community for 2 years now, almost, I think, year and a half. And the ladies that I see here, the caliber of heart that they have and the message that they have has to get into the world. So for you ladies, this hour and a half session is just $49.
Wow.
Wow.
And I'm only taking five tonight because my schedule is very full. So there's only five lucky ladies that will get to have this time with me. And if you know that's you, then what you should do is go to Madeline and visit the red shirts. Yeah, so they're also my clients. They had this session. Do you have any small words on this assessment session that you got out of it?
It's hugely comprehensive. It's a great mirror into what you're doing. You look at it and you will recognize, yes, that's right, I knew that. Some of that you don't realize it, but as soon as you see what she's written down, you realize, mm-hmm. Oh yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. So she gets you right away.
Thank you. So that's that. There's five opportunities for that. For five ladies here, but for all of you, I want you to walk away with a little something. So please take out your phones. Uh-oh, you forgot your phone. So when you get to your phone, go to the browser. Go to the browser. Isn't this great? Everybody's like, you turn your phones off for the events. Now we're gonna look and check your text messages in a moment. Go to your browser and in the, you know, where you put the address in, go to gettalk.at/fem. gettalk.at/fem. Do you see it?
Mm-hmm.
So you can enter your email address and your name there to get a free ebook called 3 Insider Secrets to Your Most Confident Stage Presence. Did anybody not find it?
gettalk.at.
You got it. /fem. I know everyone's in cyberland right now. This little ebook is something I actually originally wrote for yoga teachers to help them get out of their heads so that they can be more effective teachers. And then I've shifted just a little bit for entrepreneurs and conscious ladies. So enjoy that and come talk to me at the end of the event. It's been a pleasure. You guys are so much fun. I always love being here. Give yourself a round of applause.